Stunning announcement from the FAA. New evidence begins to show a connection between Sunday's airplane crash in Ethiopia and the Lion Air crash 5 months earlier. This came minutes after President Trump told the world that the U.S. will now ground Boeing 737 MAX 8 and MAX 9 models. Let's go right to CNN's Tom Foreman. And Tom, Boeing is still standing by its plane. What do we know about this new evidence that the FAA is citing?
The FAA says initially it had some satellite tracking on this plane, which indicated the first 3 minutes of flight, and that just didn't tell them enough to conclude what was happening with this plane. Now they say they have a more complete picture of almost the entire flight, and the pattern looks a good deal like what happened with Lion Air last fall. In other words, this idea that somehow the crew ended up fighting with software that was trying to bring the nose of the plane down while they were trying to bring the nose of the plane up. It looks enough like that that the FAA said this is somehow confirmation of enough concern that the president could take action.
Amid fierce global pressure and political alarms at home, the president finally called it.
We're going to be issuing an emergency order of prohibition to ground all flights of the 737 MAX 8 and the 737 MAX 9 and planes associated with that line. Any plane currently in the air will go to its destination and thereafter be grounded until further notice.
The order came after days of mounting worries following the Africa crash of just such a plane and serious questions about its safety. Hours after the Federal Aviation Administration insisted once again there was no evidence the Boeing jets were unsafe. And just after Canada cited new satellite tracking analysis and ordered the planes out of the sky. Yet even in issuing the order, the president praised the massive airplane manufacturer and military contractor.
Boeing is an incredible company. They are working very, very hard right now.
May God bless the United States of America and God bless Boeing.
The president has long and openly admired Boeing, hosting the CEO at Trump Tower in Mar-a-Lago, visiting Boeing factories, bragging about a multi-billion dollar deal to send planes to Vietnam.
And the reason I like the Boeing is because it's jobs for the United States.
Vietnam says that deal is now in limbo, but Boeing's ties with Team Trump remain strong. His acting Secretary of Defense is a former Boeing executive. Trump's former UN ambassador was just named to the Boeing board. In the company building the new Air Force One.
Actually, Boeing is doing it. It's going to be a new color system, red, white, and blue, and it looks phenomenal.
Still, Trump says he spoke with Boeing and others amid the storm of concern over one of the company's newest jets and said Boeing has to figure out what, if anything, is wrong with them.
And hopefully they'll very quickly come up with the answer. But until they do, the planes are grounded.
What the FAA really wants is the information from the flight data recorder and the voice recorder, the so-called black boxes. Those have been sort of inexplicably held up a little bit too long down south. Now they're being sent up to France. They're on their way there tonight. The data from that will really tell them in detail what has happened and lead toward a fix. The FAA is saying, however, that fix will not, until that fix is done, these planes will stay on the ground. Whether that takes weeks, months, or longer, we don't know. But for right now, they are parked. Jake.
All right, Tom Foreman, thanks so much. I want to bring in Peter Goals right now. He was a managing director at the National Transportation Safety Board, or NTSB. Peter, thanks for being here again. This is a major reversal. Other than 9/11, have you seen such a ground stop, something this momentous?
Well, they did ground the Dreamliner after it had problems with lithium batteries, but this is really a major reversal, and I think the FAA did not want to do it. And when it finally, the political pressure built, the tipping point was when Canada pulled out this morning. There really was no other option but to put the plane on the ground, and it was deserved.
Between Southwest Airlines and American Airlines, Boeing had nearly 60 of its 737 MAX 8 planes in the United States. This is a fairly new plane. What might this mean for future investigations should everyday travelers be worried about disruptions?
Well, here's the problem I see, is that the opening week of this tragedy has really been kind of mishandled. I think there's going to be a call for an independent panel to review not only these accidents, but to review the whole certification process and whether Boeing was too close to the FAA, whether they were taking, whether the FAA was doing the kind of rigorous oversight that is required. I wouldn't be surprised to see Congress call for that.
As somebody who worked at the NTSB, when you see President Trump praising Boeing the way he did, when you see that there's a Boeing former lobbyist running the Pentagon right now as the acting Defense Department chief, all the ties, the president eager to boost Boeing because of American jobs, does that make you uncomfortable?
It does. I mean, you know, the idea of aviation being a nonpartisan, nonpolitical industry that is driven by safety, his kind of ham-handed praising of Boeing is really, I think, uncalled for.
All right. Peter Golds, thank you so much. Appreciate your expertise and your candor.